This is the checkers game where grandson.
Good morning, Brother Andre. Welcome, Sister Crystal, to this place. Danielle, oh, welcome into this broken vessel. Sister Sharon, you desire to abide in the praises of your people. Rebel Mills, so we lift our hand and we lift our heart as we offer up this praise unto your name. Oh, welcome, Sister E, to this place. Oh, welcome, Sister Shelley, into this broken vessel. You desire to abide in the praises of your people. Sister Karen, so we lift our hand. Brother Horace, we lift our hearts as we offer up this praise unto your name. God bless you, Sister Shelley. Sister Faye, good to see you. Welcome home to this place. Oh, welcome, Sister D, to this broken vessel. You desire to abide in the praises of your people. Sister Bernadine, we lift our hands. Say we lift our hearts as we offer up this praise unto your name. Sister Verna, God bless you, God bless you. Oh, welcome, Sister Gertrude, to this place. Good afternoon, Miss Robinette. Oh, welcome, Brother Lewis. Good to see you. To this broken vessel, you desire to abide. Good afternoon, Ebenezer Lignum, Miss Laverne. Praises of your people. So we lift our hands. Good afternoon, Sister Kim. We lift our hearts as we offer up this praise unto your name. Good to see you, Miss Ethel. I need you. Yes. We lift our hands. Come on, Miss Ethel. We're going to lift up the name of Jesus. Lift our hearts as we offer up this praise unto your name. Good morning, Reverend Randy. Good to see you in the house. We lift our hands. Serena Purvis, the new bride. We lift our hearts. Sister Felicia, we offer up this praise unto your name. Daughter Tanisha's in the house. Carl's in the house. We lift our hands. Barbara Johnson's in the house. We lift our hearts. We're gonna have a good time as we offer up this praise unto your name. Sister Martha, God bless you. Precious Dennis, amen. DJ Lily, how y'all doing, babies? Oh, said we offer up this praise unto your name. Oh, yeah. We offer up this praise unto your name. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Amen. Come on, let's take a minute this morning. We're going to take a second out to amen. We're going to pray. Amen. We're going to take a minute to pray. Amen. On this morning, we bless God for being God all by himself. Come on, Sister Patricia's in the house. Amen. Good to see you. Patricia, bless you, bless you, bless you. Come on, let's pray this morning that the Spirit of the Lord might come in and move in this place. Come on, God, we just bless you on this morning. Thank you, God, how you continue to make a way out of no way. God, it's again on this Sunday that we all come, amen. Though we might be in separate places, God, we all come together of one mind, of one accord. And our hope and mind, God, this morning is that you might allow your Spirit to run from heart to heart and from breast to breast. God, wherever you find us at this morning and whatever state you find us in, God, we desire to be less of us and more like you. So our prayer is again on this morning, God, that you would move mightily on each and every heart, each and every mind, each and every spirit in this place. That God, that you might continue to remind us that you are a soon to return king. And the God that while we're here, we are counted as lambs, sheep for the slaughter. That it's God, your desire that we might, amen, go out into this world as transformed minds, proving that good, perfect, acceptable will of God. And so on this day, Holy Spirit, we're asking you to come now. We're asking you to take control of this service, that you might lead us, guide us, teach us, convict us, chastise if you must. But that in the end, we might all go out the door, amen, better than the way we came in. For on this day, Father, for those who know you're not in the pardon of sin, our prayer is today they might come running, asking, what must I do to be saved? In this service, as all services, we'll take no credit at all. But God, we'll continue to give your name the glory, the honor, and the praise. It's in Jesus' mighty name we pray. Let the church say, amen and amen. Amen and amen. Amen. Oh, I bless the Lord on this day. Greetings, my brothers and sisters. Grace be to you and peace from God our Father and from the Lord Jesus Christ. I want to welcome you again on this Sunday morning. Amen. April the 11th. Amen. As we echo the words of the Psalmist 118:24 one more time that declared that this is the day that the Lord have made, that we shall rejoice and be glad in it. I don't know about nobody else, but I'm happy, amen, to be in the number. As Miss Faith said, it's good to not only be, amen, it's good to be seen. Amen. Good to see you and good to be seen, Sister Monica. And so I want to thank you all for joining us this morning. Puddin', welcome into the house. Amen. Thank you for coming to join on our power service. Amen. And you know, we don't care where you go to church, where your name is on the roll. Amen. We want you to know that you are welcome here. And amen, you got the authority, amen, you got the, amen, permission to pull your shoes off right there at home, to jump up and down. Sister Deborah, you can throw your hands up in the air, you can wave them like you just don't care. You can do whatever you want to do, amen, as you serve, we serve the Lord with gladness, amen, and let the world know that no doubt about it, amen, that the earth is still the Lord's and the fullness thereof, Mom, Pop, Fisher, amen, and he holds us in the palm of his hand, and even in these uncertain days, y'all, Sister Wanda, if we call on the name of the Lord, he has declared that whosoever calls his name shall be saved. And so y'all know how we do this thing. Amen. It's become a regular part of our service now where we want to take a pause for the cause. We've been doing a whole lot this week. I don't know about nobody else, but God has blessed me to have a very busy week. And I thank him for having something to do. But it's been a hectic week. Amen. And I've took time, amen, to think about my many blessings. Amen. I've counted them one by one. But I need to, amen, every now and then name them. And I don't know about you, but have you taken time to name your blessings this week? Have you taken time? You probably counted them when you got up early, amen, in the morning, and your bones still worked and your feet still worked, amen. Your eyes still worked. You might have counted your blessings, but have you taken the time to name them one by one? I know there's some folks that haven't. You've been too busy this week. So let's take a pause for the cause, y'all, because you could be in the hospital, amen, on your sick bed. Take a pause for the cause, y'all, because you could have your back up against the wall with no way out, y'all. Let's take a pause for the cause that we got. Amen. God, we thank you because we got shoes on our feet. We got clothes on our back. We got food on our table. Let's take a pause for the cause and say, God, I appreciate what you've done for me. I appreciate what you're doing for me. Amen. Lord, I just bless you for, amen, how you continue to make a way out of no way. Somebody say, come on, let's play something, amen, that'll bless our hearts real good. Come on. Come on, put it in the chat. Yeah. I like this song. We used to sing this at Piney Branch when we, amen, Brother Sherman, amen, used to get up there and he would bust out in this song. Hey, daughter Sharita, come on, help me sing it this morning. Put your amen blessings in the chat. Let God know, amen, how much you appreciate him. Come on, somebody. Yeah. Tell him, Lord, I appreciate you because you did this, you did that. The Lord is blessing me right now. Oh, right now. I said the Lord is blessing me right now. Oh, right now. Come on, put it in the chat. He woke me up this morning, started me on my way. The Lord is blessing me right now. Oh, right now. Come on, one more time. The Lord, yeah, is blessing me. Come on, put it in the chat. Yeah, oh, right now. I said the Lord is blessing me right now. Oh, right now. He woke me up this morning and started me on my way. The Lord is blessing me right now. Oh, right now. How is he blessing? He woke me up this morning. I was clothed in my right mind. He did not let me sleep too late. He woke me right on time. He woke me up this morning, started me on my way. Hey, the Lord is blessing me right now. Oh, right now. Come on, I'm going to give you one more chance. Woke me up this morning. Is that your testimony? I was clothed in my right mind. Well, he did not let me sleep too late. Well, he woke right on time. Whoa, he woke me up this morning. Started me on my way. The Lord is blessing me right now. Oh, right now. Come on. Yeah. He's blessing me. The Lord is blessing me. Come on, somebody. Lord. Yeah. He's blessing me. The Lord is blessing me. All right, y'all. That's it. That's it. That's it. Amen. Get a chance to take a pause for the cause, because we know that God is good. Amen. Thank you all for participating. I get excited. Pause for the cause, where we not only count our blessings, but we get a chance to name them one by one. Amen. Reverend Brown, Brother Silas, y'all know what I'm talking about. God, amen, has been good to you. Deacon Ty, he's been good to you. Yes, he has. Amen. My brother Silas is jumping up and down right now. Amen. Because he knows that he knows that he knows that if it had not been for the Lord on his side, if God had not intervened in his situation, amen, where doctors, amen, didn't have a clue. But the God we serve, amen, has brought you through a mighty long way. Oh, help me, Holy Spirit. I'm about to get excited up in here, up in here. Bless him. Bless that wonderful name of Jesus. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. That's right, Pat. That's right. That's right. That's right. Oh, bless his name. Hallelujah. Come on, y'all. I'm holding up the prayer list. I'm about, y'all get me too excited. Amen. I want to go ahead. And we're holding up the prayer list. Amen. I got a lot of names on the list, as you can see. I've added the name of my aunt, Willow Michael. Amen. Wife of my favorite uncle, my only uncle. Amen. Well, not my only uncle, but my favorite uncle. Amen. Aunt Willow. And then I want to continue to keep Reverend Darrell Harris lifted up in prayer and his family, his wife. Amen. We're going to continue as we want to make sure we're praying for Brother Mac Purvis' mother. Amen. We want to continue to stay on our knees for Brother Jeremy Nottingham and his dad, Brother Julius Nottingham. I've added Taylor Black Page back to the top of my prayer list, y'all. I've added her back to the top of the prayer list. We need to continue to pray, amen, for God's supernatural, amen, healing power to step in some of these situations, y'all. And of course, we want to continue to pray for our country as it, amen, it seems to just be going to hell in a handbasket in so many ways, so much division, so much schism. And united we stand, but divided we fall. And the sooner we learn that, the better off we'll be. But on this morning, whatever you're going through, amen, let's touch and agree, amen. It's time to turn it over to the Lord. I've got a list here, but you got your own prayer request. Come on, type your request in the chat. While you got a minute, amen, we're going to play some music, and we're going to pray. But while we're getting ready, amen, go ahead. God, amen, we're at the virtual altar, and there's some things that you need in your life, not just to pray for these people on our list, not just standing in intercessory prayer for them, but there's some stuff that you need. And so don't be ashamed, amen, and don't be afraid. Put your specific prayer in the chat and let the Lord know, hey, God, here's what I need from you. Oh, he will grant it. I know I got a witness this morning. He will grant it. And so somebody, come on, put it in the chat, amen, as we take a minute out this morning to just bless the Lord, amen, of our soul, amen. We're going to go to him, amen, and pray this morning that he will make a way out of no way. I know somebody know what I'm talking about this morning. Come on, yes, Sister Kim, we're going to pray for your family. Yes, Sister Monica, we're going to keep your children covered in prayer. Amen. Come on, let's pray this morning. Come on. Hands forward. God, we just bless you. Come on, put it in the chat, y'all. I can't keep calling it out. I got to close my eyes, but come on, let's pray. God, we bless you on this morning for those names that are on our list in my hand, those that are on the list in our hearts, and those, God, the prayers, the requests that are being listed in our chat, even as I pray this morning. God, we thank you for, amen, being the one that we can count on in times of trouble. There's no other help we know, Lord, except for that we look to the hills, for you promised that there is that which cometh our help. And so on this morning, we lift up those, God, who might need a spiritual blessing, God. We lifting up those this morning, God, who might need a supernatural healing, God. We're lifting up those this morning, God, who the doctors, amen, have started shaking their head and don't know the solution, God. But we know that you got all power, amen. You got all the answers. You are an all-knowing God, an all-present God, all-powerful God. God, we lift it up before you this morning. Make a way out of no way. Change some things around. Turn some stuff around. Shift some atmosphere in the lives of those who believe that you will and you can. God, we know, amen, that there is nothing impossible for you to do. And so we come again on this morning with the faith the size of a mustard seed, asking, believing, and praying, God, that you will do what you said you'll do. Father, we're not going to wait until, amen, we see a breakthrough. We're not going to wait until we see our deliverance. We're not going to wait until the chains are broken and fall off. But God, in advance, because your credit is good, because your word is good, because your faith, amen, is never changing. And God, you're always faithful, even if we're not. God, we're going to, in advance, give your name glory. We're going to, in advance, give you honor. God, we're in advance going to give you praise. For it's in Jesus' mighty name we pray. Let the church say amen. Come on, come on, somebody say amen. Somebody say amen. Come on, come on, bless the Lord. Send up your prayers this morning with an amen, a hearty amen to the Lord. Amen. How many of y'all know that he can make a way out of no way? Come on, come on. How many of y'all know that? How many of you know that he'll make a way out of no? Yeah. How many of y'all know that God can and God will? Yeah. How many of y'all know that God is moving on your behalf right now? Come on. Hallelujah. Come on, say it with me. Come on. Hallelujah. For the Lord God Almighty reigns. You know he's making a way. Hallelujah. Yeah. Woo. Holy, holy are you, Lord God Almighty. Worthy is the Lamb, worthy is the Lamb. You are holy, holy are you, Lord God Almighty. Come on, worship. Worthy is the Lamb. Yeah, worthy is the Lamb. You are holy. Yeah. He's making a way. Come on, y'all. Hallelujah. Yeah, he's making a way. Come on, you got to feel it. You got to feel it. Hallelujah. Even now, you can give him the highest praise. Hallelujah. For the Lord God Almighty reigns. He, come on, y'all. Come on. Yeah, sing. Oh. Hallelujah. Holy. Holy are you, Lord God Almighty. Worthy is the Lamb. Worthy is the Lamb. You are holy. Holy are you, Lord God Almighty. Come on. Worthy is the Lamb. Worthy is the Lamb. You are holy. One more time. Holy are you, Lord God Almighty. Worthy is the Lamb. Worthy is the Lamb. You are holy. Amen. Oh, bless the Lord of my soul. Amen. Woo! Lord have mercy. Amen. And so now, my brothers and sisters, offering time, 2 Corinthians 9:7 says each of us should give what we have decided in our hearts to give, not reluctantly, or not because you're being made to, not because you're under compulsion, for God loves a cheerful giver. And so the song is going to play. I'm going to let it play for a minute. But you ought to already have your offering. Remember, we talked about this a few weeks ago. You ought to already have your offering prepared. Ought to already have prayed over it. Ought to already know what it is that you're going to give the Lord. Amen. So come on, I'm going to just give you a minute. I ain't going to give you a long time. But go ahead. Go get your offering. Come on. Come on. Oh. Our sins and griefs to bear. Whoa. privilege to carry everything to God in prayer. Listen. Oh, what peace we often forfeit. Oh, what needless pain we bear. All because we do not carry everything to God in prayer. Amen. Told you it wasn't going to be long. You ought to already have your offering. Come on. Let's take a minute right now. We're going to pray. God, we thank you this morning for giving us an opportunity to bless you with what we have. Amen. A portion of what we've been given. Pray, God, that you would bless those who have to give. Special blessing, God, on those who want to give and have it not. Prayer is that you would open up the windows of heaven, pour them out a blessing so that they too might be able to give. Amen. When opportunity presents itself. God, take out a little bit. Do exceedingly and abundantly above all that we ask or think, and that it might be used for the uplifting of your kingdom on earth. In Jesus' name we pray. Let the church say amen and amen. Come on. Praise God from whom all blessings flow. Praise him, all creatures here below. Praise him above, ye heavenly hosts. Praise Father, Son, and Holy Ghost. Amen. Amen. So it's preaching time. Amen. Preaching time is here. Amen. I want you to go grab, amen, your Bibles on this morning. I want you to turn to a, shouldn't take you but a minute to get to it. I want you to go to 2 Timothy. I want you to look at verse, go down all the way to the end, last chapter. I want you to look at verse 4. Amen, Sister DeWitt. We're going to go to a very familiar passage this morning because we need to, amen, find some root this morning. We need to go back, amen, to where, amen, our foundation is. We need to, amen, remember what thus saith the Lord. We need to go back, amen, so that we might get ourselves realigned with what God would have us to do, not only as a church, amen, but individually, amen, in these last and evil days. 2 Timothy 4, amen. We're going to read down 1, amen, 1 through 4, amen. Come on, 2 Timothy 4, 1 through 4, amen. 2 Timothy 4, 1 through 4. Come on, let's read together. If you read fast, I need you to slow down. If you read slow, I need you to speed up, amen. 2 Corinthians 4, 1 through 4. Come on, let's read together. Paul says, I charge thee therefore before God and the Lord Jesus Christ, who shall judge the quick and the dead at his appearing and his kingdom. Preach the word. Preach the word. Be instant in season and out of season. Reprove, rebuke, exhort with all long suffering and doctrine. For the time will come when they will not endure sound doctrine, but after their own lust shall they heap to themselves teachers having itching ears, and they shall turn, amen, away their ears from the truth, and shall be turned unto fables. Amen. They shall turn away their ears from the truth and shall be turned unto fables. Amen. The Lord would have us to get serious, amen, to focus, amen, on that. Amen. A part of, amen, verse 2. Subject this morning is time to just preach the word. It's time to just preach the word. Tell somebody in the house, look at them, tell them, say, it's time to just preach the word. Amen. It's time to just preach the word. Amen. God, thank you this morning for another opportunity. Prayer is now, God, that you would look past weak flesh, touch spirit, make preaching easy. God, give me all you got so that I might give all that's been given to the lamb and to the sheep. God, we thank you in Jesus' name. Amen. So my brothers and sisters, today we have been directed to be reminded of the most basic guidance of the Bible, that when we go out to minister to a dying world, when we go out to speak to those who are searching for a more excellent way, when we converse with those who are downtrodden and those who are depressed and who are filled with questions, amen, that when we find ourselves asking when we're up against the wall, that we, amen, not take the opportunity when that comes to build our own selves up, and that we not take the opportunity to show off, amen, under the pretense of our perception of biblical theology, or even try to push our own agenda on those who might not be able to discern our ulterior motive. But that in each and every circumstance, when opportunity presents itself, that we not waste the opportunity that God gives us to tell somebody about Jesus. Not waste the opportunity to share the good news of this gospel, so that folks might come to trust the Lord with all their hearts, that they might come to not lean to their own understanding, and in all their ways, amen, in all their situation and all their circumstances, they might come to acknowledge the God of heaven and earth. You might wonder why we find ourselves here in this scripture passage this morning, in this very familiar passage of scripture, and it's because I've listened for guidance. As I listened this week, as I prepared, amen, got ready to prepare, I listened for the voice of the Lord, and this week I found myself, as always, sitting with Layla, my baby girl, listening to some of the preachers, amen, on YouTube, and now, you know, normally Layla listens to a majority of gospel music, especially that man Jarrell Smalls. She loved that man. Amen. I got a letter this morning. Uh-huh. She liked that man. But this week, amen, for some reason, I noted that we listen to a lot of preaching also. And Layla, amen, if you sit around her, amen, she don't linger on any one preacher for any considerable length of time. But for the time that we did listen to each preacher, I heard, amen, the Lord had me hear one thing that was so obvious and clear, amen, that many, amen, folks, amen, when given the opportunity to speak the truth and to speak the word, they use God-given platform as a place to speak their own minds, speak their own words. They use it as an opportunity to dupe people into sending money in exchange for colored napkins and vials of spring water. They use the time to talk trash about the president or persuade folks to not believe what they see and hear in the news. They use it to speak out to perpetuate the conspiracy stories about COVID-19, or use it to spout their opinion and their recommendation on whether or not to take the vaccine. But what was clear, and it's very clear, that too much time is spent talking about man's disarray when we ought to be talking about the gospel. That too much time spent talking about man's disorders when we ought to be talking about the gospel. Too much time talking about man's dismay and man's being divided all over the place, and not enough of that precious time spent on sharing the good news, or sharing the gospel of Christ. For it alone is the power unto God, unto salvation to everyone that believe, and therein is the righteousness of God revealed from faith to faith. For my word declares, it's written that the just shall live by faith. And so today, let us quickly use our precious time to talk about the good news. For woe unto me if I don't preach the gospel. Shame on me if I don't preach the living word. That is the very specific point that's written in this second personal letter written by elderly brother Paul to this young man called of God to succeed him in the ministry named Timothy. Paul, y'all, a proven warrior of the word who's carried the torch, amen, ever since that fateful day that he met Jesus on the road to Damascus. Paul, amen, writes this important piece of guidance as he sits in prison, amen, just some days away from death. Amen. Paul is coming to the end of his earthly journey. He tells Tim, I'm ready to be offered and my time of departure is at hand. And so with this heartfelt letter to his spiritual son, he encourages this young preacher what he needs to do. Amen. As the task is falling on his shoulders now to pick up the bloodstained banner and to continue to tell a dying world about Jesus Christ. God directs Paul to pass the torch to teach and to preach, amen, that this is the acceptable year of the Lord. He passes it on to Timothy and, amen, to send him a letter to warn him about warfare and to exhort him during the warfare and to encourage him not to give up doing, amen, as he goes through the warfare, to help him overcome trials and tribulations and temptation, the pain and persecution that comes on all of us when we don't mind sharing the world that we've been born again. So Paul, y'all, when we read this morning, he's poured out his heart to Timothy in two letters, and he's banking all that he has on this young man who has unfeigned faith. Paul is saying, Timothy, you don't need a lot of money. You don't need a lot of clothes. You don't need a lot of brains. All you need is faith the size of a mustard seed. That when, amen, tell folks that when they get tired of the issues in this world and when they get tired of the drama, that they ought to be able to speak with boldness and authority and move mountains of this life right out of their way. With the understanding that with God on my side, I don't care what trouble comes. I don't care where trouble comes from. I don't care whom brings the trouble. Amen. I know that I know that I know that I know that when I got Jesus on my side, that he will bring me out. Can I drop a dime right here? Because even today, this letter's encouragement to you and I in this day of pestilence and in this time of disease and earthquake and floods and the heartlessness that we see among brothers and sisters. For this first century world was not much different than our own. Y'all, there's nothing new under the sun because sin is still sin. And that which one does and they shouldn't do, they still do. Doing it, and that which they shouldn't do, amen, but they ought to do, they're still not doing it. And so the world is filled with distorted values and uncontrolled lusts and deceit, misguided doctrines, and confused Christians, y'all, who've forgotten which side they're fighting on and think it's all right to put their perceptions and their prejudice and their positions, amen, above the gospel. And so this is the time, saint. This is a season, saints, that if we're going to talk about anything, it ought to be about the gospel. If we're going to share about anything, if we're going to have a discussion about anything to anybody, it ought to not be about us. It ought to not be about the news on CNN. It ought to not be about COVID-19. It ought to not be about what the devil is doing. It ought to not be about the politics of this time. But it ought to be about the fact that God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son. That the Lord looked past our faults and he sent the Lamb who knew no sin that became sin for us so that we might be reconciled back to God. It ought to be about the fact that the Lamb was slain on a tree, that he died at his own choosing, but he was raised after 3 days and sits now on the right hand of the Father, so that whosoever calls on him and whosoever believes on him shall have everlasting life with him. Amen. But please don't take my word about the urgency of the time we find ourselves in to get back to the truth. For God use Paul to tell Timothy in that day, and he's using Paul to tell us in this day, don't be naive, y'all. There's some difficult days ahead as the end time approaches. We're going to find people who are going to love themselves only and going to love money above all things. We're going to find people that's going to be proud and boastful. They're going to sneer, amen, and scorn God. They're going to be disobedient to their parents. They're going to be ungrateful folks, amen. They're going to just be downright dirty, dirty bad. They're going to be hard-headed, amen. Constant liars, amen. Troublemakers, amen. Going to be rough, going to be cruel. Help me, Holy Ghost. And for those that try to be good, they're going to turn up their nose at them. They're going to betray their friends. They're going to be hot-headed, the Bible says, puffed up with pride. And amen, they're going to go to church, but they're going to make a show of religion. They'll have no, amen, stomach for solid teaching, but instead they're going to fill themselves up on spiritual junk food. They're going to fill themselves up on catchy opinions that'll tickle their fancy. They're going to turn their backs on the truth and run after fables. Those kind of folk, y'all, they're going to talk smooth talk. Amen. They're going to take advantage of folk. They're going to take up new religions and call it the truth, y'all. They're going to exploit folks every chance they get. They're going to be false teachers everywhere, is what the word says. It's not me talking. They're going to be folks who reject the faithful, amen, who get twisted in their thinking, amen. But the Bible declares that in these days, nothing will come of these imposters, because those who have a discerning spirit and the knowledge of truth will see through the mess. But I want you to understand, there are those who are young babes, those who are still searching for the truth, and those who need to hear the good news, need to hear the gospel of Jesus Christ. And so Paul encourages him, Timothy, and us to proclaim the message with intensity, but keep it simple. Amen. Proclaim the message with intensity. Stay on the watch. Challenge and warn. Urge folk, no matter what, and keep the message alive. Don't ever quit. Keep it simple. Just preach the word. Preach the word. Preach Jesus born. Preach Jesus living. Preach Jesus crucified. Preach Jesus risen. Preach Jesus returning. And let me tell you, don't get hung up on the word preach and think that this message is only for those who got a title and stand in the pulpit. For the word preach is keruso, and it means to be a herald, to publish, to proclaim openly, public proclamation of the gospel and any matter pertaining to it, telling something which has already been done, which tells us that we don't need to have a degree to talk about this gospel. We don't need to have a piece of paper from an ordination council or university to talk about this gospel. We don't need a special license that's been voted on by the church body to talk about this gospel. But anybody, no matter the education, anybody, no matter the gender, anybody, no matter your state in life, and amen, and many times in the case of this young man, anybody, regardless of age, when you know the Lord for yourself, can preach the word, can preach Jesus born, can preach him born in Bethlehem in the city of David, can preach him as a little babe wrapped in swaddling clothes and lying in a manger, can preach about the shepherds that came to pay homage, can preach about the wise men who came to bring gifts, can preach, amen, the good news, because that's what we ought to be talking about. When you're knowing for yourself, you can preach the gospel, that the story goes even deeper and it gets more detailed. You can tell the folks that he's the Holy One who came out of heaven, who thought it not robbery with God and took on human flesh. You can tell them, amen, when you're knowing for yourself, that he is the one who healed the blind. He is the one that made the lame walk. He is the one that preached his heart out, amen, day in and day out for 3 years, amen, to proclaim the truth and call folk to righteousness, to warn them that the kingdom of God is at hand. Repent now and believe the gospel. Amen. When you know the Lord for yourself, amen, you can speak with conviction about the fact, amen, that you know that he commanded water into wine, that he spoke to the wind and made it hush, that he spoke to the demons, amen, and they moved at his command. Help me, Holy Ghost. When you know it for yourself, you can preach the gospel and you can declare, amen, that one day this Jesus who was oppressed and afflicted, that one day this Jesus who was bought as a lamb to the slaughter, one day this Jesus, amen, who was put to death, amen, so that you and I might be, amen, bought into righteousness. This Jesus who was numbered with the transgressions, who bare the sin of many and the transgressions of all, amen, on a hill called Calvary. When you know that you know that you know, you can tell somebody that the sin of the world was laid on him. And though the Father still loved him, he couldn't look on him. Help me, Holy Ghost. When he drank from the cup long enough, amen, for the Father to accept his final sacrifice, for the last time and cried out with a loud voice, amen, it is finished. Into thy hands I commend my spirit. Help me, Holy Ghost. This Jesus, this word lets us know, amen, with the final breath, that, amen, he had finished the work that was left undone by the yearly sacrifice of bulls and goats. This word, when you preach it, make it known that with his words and his death, he closed out the contract in blood that was made in heaven when he said, prepare me a body so that I can go redeem mankind. If you know the Lord for yourself, you can proclaim that that's not the end of the story, because the good news of the gospel is he's not gone for good. He's not sitting idle, but he's in glory, and he's preparing a place for the believers. He's in glory, making intercession on our behalf. He's in glory, speaking into the Father's ear, and in due season, this Jesus is coming back, that he is a soon to return king. And for those who got faith, and those who have acknowledged him as Lord and made him Savior, one day shall be caught up to meet him in the air, and so shall we forever be with the Lord. And I don't know about nobody else, but surely, that's definitely good news. But unfortunately, we're living in a day when preachers want a big church so bad, want a lot of members so bad, that they've gotten confused about their calling. They've forgotten to confuse about what it means to be elevated. People in the church have gotten saved, and now they done got, amen, complacent. They forgot what it's like to stand before the people, amen, to know God, amen, and not take advantage of the opportunity to speak life into somebody else's heart, speak life into somebody else's situation that would transform their life. And the reality of the matter this morning is it's not the devil who's messing us up. It's us who's messing us up. It's the preachers and it's the people who are not sharing the gospel. It's the people and the preachers who are not talking enough about Jesus. And so, amen, people are wilding out. Not just, amen, the sinner man, but the deacons in the church. Not just the wino on the corner, but the church mothers are tripping in the club. It's not just the person on the floor on Saturday night, but it's the members in the pews who are acting like pure fools because they're no longer hearing the word of life. This word is meant to warn us not to be likened to a good joke as an icebreaker. It's to warn us not to be mixed with roasting, amen, politicians, amen, on Capitol Hill. It's to warn us not to be fixed and confused with the latest sports story or to beat up on the church membership. No, those things ought not be, y'all. When we are given the opportunity to make a stand for Jesus Christ, we ought to use these precious moments wisely. Use them to preach the gospel to the poor so that the brokenhearted might be healed, so that the captives might be delivered, so that those who are blind might recover sight, so that those who are bruised might be set free. Preach the acceptable year of the Lord, understanding that what we say that comes out of our mouth is able to shift the atmosphere and to change lives of men, women, boys, and girls. And to make sure that that happens, we can't be preaching about Congress. We've got to preach the word. We can't just talk about police and crime. We've got to preach the word. We can't get caught up with talking about whether we ought to wear a mask or not, or take a vaccine or not, because we got to preach the word. Yes, those matters are important, but hearing about those matters will not help somebody who is struggling with life, will not help the drug addict who's trying to get rid of the drugs, will not help the alcoholic who's trying to kick, amen, Johnny Walker to the curb, will not help the young lady who, amen, who has been caught in adultery, amen, reputation jacked up, and wants to know, is there a way for me to be restored? Can my gown be spiritually made white again? No, my brothers and sisters, the only way to break the chains, the only way to assure folks that earth has no sorrow, that heaven cannot heal, the only way to make folks understand that the love of God will never take us to a place, and through a place, that the grace grace of God can't bring us out of that place is to make sure that we stay faithful to our service and that we continue to go and spread the news with the understanding that when we build up the church of the living God, that the gates of hell cannot prevail against it if we would just take a stand and preach the word. So we must preach. But even more importantly, said preach it in season and out of season. Paul says we ought to preach it no matter the program or the plan. We ought to preach it no matter the event or the episode. We ought to preach it no matter the curriculum or the cause. We ought to preach the word. Preach the word when folks want to hear it. Preach the word when they don't want to hear it. It don't matter who the audience is or the attendees. It doesn't matter who's in the crowd or the congregation. It doesn't matter. We have an obligation. If we've been saved by the blood, we've got an obligation to preach the word in season and even, amen, when they don't want to hear it. Colossians 1:25, y'all, says we got to preach. We got to warn every man, teach him, amen, so that we might present every man perfect in Jesus Christ. Oh, help me, God. That's why God uses all of us. He uses our gifts, our talents, our time, so that we might bring what he's given us, what the Spirit has given us, to the table, y'all, so that together all of us might not just be perfected and not just know our purpose, but that the whole body might be edified, so that we might come to know together that God is merciful and gracious, so that we might come to know together that he's long-suffering and abundant in goodness and truth, so that we might know together that our God is almighty, he's a righteous and holy God, amen. We ought to know together, amen, that it's at that place called Calvary where mercy and truth come together, where the righteousness of God and the peace of God come together, where the love of God and the grace of God come together and is made available by the blood of the Christ, the living God, to folks like you and me. And because of his sacrifice, we can now connect to a God that never changes, amen, because of the blood relationship that's been given to us through his only begotten Son. And I want you to understand this morning, we are smack dab in the middle of a time when the world and the church will no longer endure sound doctrine. We're right in the middle of the time when the church has got itching ears, when they're turning away from the truth, when they're, amen, falling back on their own lust, when they're looking for teachers who will tell them what they want to hear. But the warning signs of the day make it clear. Amen. If you don't look, time is running out, y'all. The storm is coming. Nighttime is on the way. And it's now time to get serious about preaching the word. Oh, it's all right to preach and hear about Daniel in the lion's den, three Hebrew boys in the fiery furnace, and Jonah, a man who was delivered from the fish belly. But somewhere in this modern time ought to be somebody who knows enough about Jesus Christ that they can stand up in the midst of wherever they are and preach up the word of a living God. Talk about Jesus, who is the Christ. Somewhere there's somebody, amen, who ought to be able to tell the world that through Christ we're reconciled, amen, back to God, and that the good news is that the dad who is looking, amen, to be the priest, protector, and provider can find help in Jesus. That the mother who's looking, amen, for forgiveness, for falling down on the job of being a virtuous woman, can find help through Jesus. Amen, for the son or daughter who strayed away to the far country, amen, and now coming back and looking for forgiveness and mercy, can find, amen, all that they need in Jesus. But the sad truth is, many don't want to hear the word no more. They don't want to hear about Jesus, because the word is meant to expose our weak places. The word is meant to make us face our sin. It's the word of God, y'all. It's meant to be alive and active. It's meant to be sharper than two-edged sword. It's meant to penetrate even to the soul and spirit, even to the joint and the marrow. It's meant to judge our thoughts and the attitudes in our heart. And like it or not, every part of scriptures God breathed. Every part of scripture is useful in one way or another. It shows us truth. It exposes our rebellion. It corrects our mistake, y'all. It trains us to live God's way. And through the word, y'all, we are put together and shaped for the task that God has ordained for each of us to do. Oh, yeah, yeah. And people do run. And they're going to continue to run. Because to hear about Jesus is to hear the truth about yourself. And folk don't want to hear, amen, that they're a sinner. Amen, because the gospel will leave the sinner man empty of everything earthly. Broken down, y'all, in a place of nakedness. Take away all your toys. Take away all your idols. And it'll leave you exposed. Leave you, amen, stripped down. Pull off your self-righteousness. Show you your filthy rags, amen, stripped away. And leave you under, the microscope of God's righteousness and his holiness. But understand that men and women need to know the truth of what Jesus said about us, that we are gone out of the way. We become unprofitable. Amen. And there's none that do good. No, not one. Amen. But in other words, we love us. Amen. We love ourselves. We will follow after our own passion. Amen. So the gospel reminds us that there is none righteous. No, not one. Amen. Our throats are open sepulcher. Amen. Our feet are swift to shed blood. Amen. The way of peace, we don't know nothing about. And so we got to preach and we got to warn that there's a sincere fear of God that ought to be in the house. Amen. Because there's no more trembling at the cross. No, nobody falls at his God's feet as dead men anymore. Nobody, amen, even in the church house, amen, has the decency to stand up and declare before a living God, amen, woe is me. I am a wretch undone. And I know that because if church folk really feared God, they would, amen, be silent before him. If they really feared God, they wouldn't just bring any old thing to him, but their worship would be real. Their worship wouldn't just be hollering and shouting on cue, but their worship would be out of awesome reverence and fear. Amen. And so this morning, as we get out of here, I just want to say, amen, the Lord has led us here because we need to get back to just preaching the word. It's time to just preach the word. I don't know, amen, it might sound a little harsh, but I know God is tired of folk just coming to church and playing with him. And we ought to be tired of them too. And our prayer ought to be, Lord, deliver us from folk who don't want to know you. Lord, deliver us from folk who don't want to change. Lord, deliver us from folk who content to play with your word, who want to stay the same, who have no desire to live for you. Lord, deliver us from them. And then God, give us the boldness to go declare and to preach and teach unto them that the wages of sin is death, but the gift of God is eternal life. And that, amen, there's no other name given among men whereby we might be saved, so that they might turn from their wicked ways. They might come asking, what must I do to be saved? Let's leave together with this morning, that Jesus Christ is not in a fire escape from hell. He is Lord. He's not the doormat that we can just step on to get, amen, away from the devil. Bible says, if any man confess with his mouth that Jesus is Lord and believe in his heart that God have raised him from the dead, he shall be saved. That's the good news. That's the word we ought to carry forth. And whenever we get the opportunity to stand for the Lord, the only thing that we ought to talk about is what thus saith the Lord. Tell them the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth. And I know that's what I'm going to do. I've learned even more so since we made this decision to go virtual because of COVID, that I'm not just here, amen, to just pastor a church. I'm here to preach the word. I'm not just here to see how many folk I can baptize, but I'm here to preach the word. I'm not here to dazzle nobody with my mastery of theological tenets because many folk wouldn't understand what I'm talking about, but I'm here to preach the word. I'm here to tell somebody, tell anybody, tell everybody what the Lord can do, that the God we serve can deliver, that the God we serve can redeem, that the God we serve can reconcile, that the God we serve can set free, that he can break chains, that he can save our souls. I've come here to tell somebody, amen, that somewhere I read, y'all, that through this Jesus came through 42 generations, that the good news started just like that, that he came to settle the sin debt for you and I. Somewhere I read that the angel said his name would be Jesus because he would save the people from their sins. Somewhere I read that this Jesus was born in a manger to a man, a mother, virgin named Mary, and a man named Joseph. Somewhere I read that he showed by miraculous works that he was all man and that he was all God. That this Jesus pulled coins right out of fish's mouth. That this Jesus fed over 5,000 with a 7-piece fish dinner. That this Jesus could speak to demons that was in a man who was hurting himself and made the demons come out and obey his voice and jump into a bunch of pigs, and the pigs jumped off the cliff. But the biggest thing that I read and I understand and I'm glad about is that, amen, the night he went to the garden, I'm glad about the night that they came to take him. I'm glad about that he decided not his will, but God's will be done. I'm glad about that he allowed them to take him to Calvary. I'm glad about the fact he let them put nails in his feet. I'm glad about that he let them put nails in his hand. I'm glad about the fact that he let them, amen, raise them high and they stretched him wide. I'm glad about the fact that he showed that he can save even until the last by declaring to the thief that this day you shall be with me in paradise. I'm glad, help me, Holy Ghost, that he gave his life willingly. I'm glad, y'all, that they pierced his sword and the blood flowed down. I'm glad that he was put in a borrowed tomb and that they had the guards there. I'm glad that on the third day morning when they went looking for him, that they found the angels there that declared with all truth that why do you seek the living among the dead? That he is not here, for he has risen. I'm glad that he showed up, amen, in their midst, and on that last fateful day, that he stood on the mountain and declared unto them that I've got all power in heaven and earth in my hand, so that you and I would never have to fear again hell, death, and the grave, but that God confession through our faith that showered with grace would save us and keep us and cover us until his return. I don't know about you, but I'm glad, y'all, that we can, amen, minister to people, amen, who have no hope today, who have no joy today. Amen, that the Lord's desire is that, amen, all of us would be saved and that we might come to know that God can and God will deliver us out of all of our afflictions. And God's hope and desire is that we church folk who know him for ourselves would get up off of our behind and start witnessing to the truth. That we would get up off our behind and let folks know that Jesus cares, and that no matter what the issue is that makes a man a person unclean, no matter what the issue is that makes a person unworthy, no matter what the situation is that makes a person feel useless, that the power of the blood still works, that the fount that flows is able to cleanse from the utmost, and Jesus can fix it like he said he would. We've come today to preach, amen, unsaved folks, to preach Jesus. We've come to preach to the backside of the day, amen, Jesus. We've come to preach to those, amen, that have to worry about where the next dollar come from, who have to worry about the distance between the door and the altar, who worry about what folks might say about them. We've come to preach the word of the living God, to know that there's a Savior who is tired, amen, of folks pretending, but he is there to lift up the weary. He is there to help out the burden. He is there to give strength to the weaker. He is there to lift up the load of the heavy burden. That our Jesus is our refuge. And that whenever we find ourselves in need, we can take everything to God in prayer. Oh, I want somebody to know. Preach the word so folks might know that Jesus is the head. Amen. And with Jesus as our head, we become the head and not the tail. Preach the word so folks will know that there is a balm in Gilead that's good for the sin-sick soul. Preach the word so people will know that there is a rock of ages, that there is a lover of our soul who looks past our faults, who looks past our faults, who looks past our past, amen, our future that's messed up, amen, and sees our needs and makes sure that our messed up future becomes one that is fruitful. Can I get out of here this morning? But as I leave y'all, is there a witness in the house who can declare, Pastor, I'm still bold enough, even in these last days, I'm still bold enough, when everybody's turning away from the truth, I'm still bold enough to tell this dying world, amen, I'm unashamed of the gospel of Jesus Christ. I'm still bold enough to go out and declare that the wages of sin is still death. Still bold enough to declare that God loves a sinner, but he hates the sin. I'm still bold enough to go declare that you better let go of trying to have a good religion and press toward the mark and secure a great relationship in Jesus Christ. I'm still bold enough to make it clear that just because Jesus left earth in Acts chapter 2, just because we don't see him, don't mean that he's gone. Don't mean that he's dead. Don't mean that he's lost. And it don't mean that he's forsaken us. Amen. He's there just waiting for the Father to flip the switch. And 1 Thessalonians 4 says that when God, who has decided all seasons in his hands, that when we least expect it, he's going to make daytime nighttime. He's going to let the clock run out, and we're going to hear the sound of the trump. We're going to hear the voice of the archangel, and we're going to see Jesus come back in all his glory. But until then, church, until that time, church, whether in season or out of season, we need to just preach the word. When folks want to hear it, and when they don't, we need to just preach the word. When they feel like listening and when they don't, we need to just preach the word. Continue to give God the glory. Continue to give God the praise. Continue to give God the honor. Continue to give God all our confidence. Continue to give God our love, and make sure and are very sure that every chance, every opportunity, that we just preach the word. Amen, amen, and amen. Help me, Holy Ghost. Help me, Holy Ghost. Oh, Lord Jesus. Preach the word. Preach the word. Preach the word. Lord, help me, Jesus. Oh, Lord. Help me, Jesus. Come on, as we get out of here on this morning. Come on, pray with me. God, we thank you on another day. We bless you, Father, for how you continue to make a way out of no way. And we thank you, God, for reminding us not to use our opportunity that you give us to talk about anything else but what thus saith the Lord. Teach us, Father, to be bold in these last and evil days, while everybody else is using the platform that you've given them to talk about everything but Jesus. Lord, continue to put it on our heart and our mind that we need to spread the word. We need to be talking about the gospel. We need to let somebody know about the good news that you came, you died, you rose, but you are soon to return king. And yet, God, while you're away, that Jesus is still making a way out of no way. That for those who searched all over, couldn't find nobody, that you are the way, the truth, and the life. We thank you again for another Sunday. We bless your holy name. And now unto him who is able to keep us from falling, present us faultless before his throne with exceeding joy. To the only wise God, our Father, be both grace, majesty, dominion, and power, henceforth, now, and ever. Let the church say amen. I love you, Lord, and I lift my voice to worship you. Oh, my soul rejoice. Take joy, my King, in what you hear, and let it be a sweet, sweet sound in your ear. I gotta get out of here. We exalt thee, we exalt thee, we exalt thee, oh Lord. Look, I gotta go. Come on. We exalt thee. Trying to let it go. We exalt thee. We exalt thee. I gotta go, y'all. Oh, Lord. Come on. I thank you all for being in the house one more time. God bless you. Let's continue to use every opportunity we have to go tell somebody, everybody, and anybody, whether they'll listen or whether they won't. Let's be bold enough to just preach the word. Tell them about Jesus. A God who can save. Amen. A God who loves us. A God who saves us. A God who keeps us. God the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. And I can tell you right now, God will bless you. Thank you. Amen. For being with us on this day, fellowshipping again. If God willing, we'll see you next week. Better yet, amen. Check out on Wednesday night. Go to Piney Branches. Amen. Our page. Amen. Pull up our Bible study information. Come and see us on Wednesday night. We have a great Bible study. Folks from all over the place join in. You don't have to be a member of the church. You're a member of the body of Christ. Come on in and let's, amen, lift up the name of Jesus and let's learn together. Amen. I love you. I'll see you next week. Let me get out of here. Amen. God be with you. Might he watch between you and me while we're absent one from another. God bless. Love you. See you next week. Goodbye.